Right now, what we're doing is building an antenna that will track fish that have a microchip in them, which is the same kind of microchip you would use for your dog or cat.
The microchips are being inserted into 53,000 tiny Chinook salmon. From there, the fish are released into a new temporary home in the Yolo Bypass.
We're doing this so that we can track their movement between different agricultural habitat types.
It's all part of a collaborative effort among UC Davis researchers, local farmers, nonprofits, and government agencies to see if rice fields in the summer might make for good fish habitat come winter.
This project's really neat because we are finally getting back to basics, that we realize salmon need floodplains.
After decades of building new levees and dams, less than 5% of Central Valley floodplains, nature's nursery for salmon, remain. This floodplain is used to grow rice only part of the year, making this project a great fit for farmers as well.
The bypass is probably the toughest area to farm. Because of the flooding, because of the late flooding, with everything that brings with it, the uncertainty, the weeds, the erosion, and everything else, by having more uses out here, it actually underwrites a lot of the farming and a lot of the infrastructure.
Scientists expect these fish to double their weight each week during their 6 to 8 week stay. That means they'll be more fit for their tough journey out to sea and more likely to return home as adults to spawn the next generation of salmon.
So we say that that's a win for farms, for flood control, for fins and for feathers, because you're providing good habitat to both fish and birds on lands that really provide high quality agriculture and some of the most important flood benefits in the state.
Along the Yolo Bypass, Kristen Samos for UC Davis.